Hello everybody. I apologize for the hand camera action I have going on right now, but it's actually quite late here in Austin, Texas, and it's the night before my wife's birthday, and I have to get up quite early to make her some breakfast like a good husband should on their wife's birthday. So, but I actually just finished editing a video, and the video covers William Shakespeare's play Julius Caesar, which is one of my favorites, if not my favorite, of Shakespeare's plays. And I think it's actually a little bit underappreciated. And I hope this video will help you understand why. So, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel to encourage me to make more videos and to spread the good word. So, thank you so much. Enjoy.
In the twilight years of the Roman Republic, Julius Caesar took center stage, rising through the ranks to become dictator of Rome. Many loved Julius Caesar because of his successes as the general in Gaul, and as a praetor and later consul in politics, but some hated him for the civil war that he started, which led to the deaths of many great Romans, including Pompey, his rival and friend. The death of Julius Caesar was immortalized beautifully in the writings of William Shakespeare. This play is perhaps my favorite of Shakespeare's because it has brilliant monologues and covers an incredibly fascinating moment in history. The Royal Shakespeare Company recognizes three major themes of this play: superstition, ambition, and loyalty. Please keep these in mind as we move forward. In the opening scene, we see plebeians cheering for Caesar because he was victorious against Pompey in the Civil War, but the tribunes break them up. A soothsayer then warns Caesar of the Ides of March, March 15th. But this is ignored. Brutus is a senator with a fair bit of power who hasn't made up his mind about Caesar and wonders if soon the Republic will fall with Caesar becoming the king. Brutus believes himself to be an honorable man and is somewhat easy to sway because of his ego. Cassius, another senator, despises Caesar and is likely jealous. The two senators are told that Mark Antony tried to give Caesar a crown three times but was repeatedly turned down. Cassius hatches a plot to leave letters at Brutus's house, which will look like citizens complaining of Julius Caesar's power, and he convinces Brutus that assassination is the best path forward. On March 15th, Caesar returns to the Senate after ignoring many warnings about the threats to his life. Cassius, Brutus, and other senators seize the opportunity and brutally stab him. There, he breathes his last breaths and says, "Et tu, Brute?" which means, "And you, Brutus?" The conspirators all believe that they will be met with cheers from the citizens of Rome, but this is not the case. Many people panic and are unsure how to feel. Brutus believes that he is the most honorable of all men, and that he can win over the people, so he gives Mark Antony, one of Caesar's closest allies, a chance to speak to the citizenry on Caesar's behalf, which turns out to be a fatal mistake. What follows is one of the greatest speeches ever written.
I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do lives after them. The good is oft interred with their bones. So let it be with Caesar. The noble Brutus hath told you Caesar was ambitious. If it was so, it was a grievous fault. And grievously hath Caesar answered it. Here on the leave of Brutus and the rest, for Brutus is an honorable man. So are they all honorable men. Come I to speak in Caesar's funeral. He was my friend, faithful and just to me. But Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. He hath brought many captives home to Rome, whose ransoms did the general coffers fill. Did this in Caesar seem ambitious? When did the poor have cried, Caesar hath wept? Ambition should be made of sterner stuff. Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. You all did see that on the Lupercal I thrice presented him a kingly crown, which he did thrice refuse. Was this ambition? Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and sure he is an honorable man. I speak not to disprove what Brutus spoke, but here I am to speak what I do know. You all did love him once, not without cause. What cause withholds you then to mourn for him? Oh, judgment, thou art led to brutish beasts, and men have lost their reason. Bear with me, my heart is in the coffin there with Caesar, and I must pause till it come back to me.
From there, the people beg to hear Caesar's last will and testament, which offers his money to every Roman citizen and for his private gardens to become public. This enrages the crowd because they realize that he was the true honorable man. Mark Antony, Octavian, who soon to become Augustus Caesar as he was Caesar's adopted son, and Lepidus form a coalition against the traitors. Brutus and Cassius flee and form their own armies, which begins another civil war. Soon these two start a quarrel, as Brutus has a high sense of honor and doesn't believe that Cassius lives up to that honor, and Cassius is only working in his own self-interest, taking payment for higher positions in the army, for instance. Cassius's men are mostly defeated by Octavian, so he sends a messenger to see how the rest of his army is faring. When the messenger sees Cassius's friend Titinus surrounded by Romans, the messenger assumes that he is captured. Cassius then tells the messenger to kill him, which he does. Titinus later arrives because it turns out that he was actually just surrounded by his own soldiers cheering for victory. Titinus kills himself too. Brutus later takes his own life as well after hearing of the death of these two men. The play ends with Antony saying that Brutus was truly an honorable man because he did what he believed was best for Rome and didn't just do things that were in his own self-interest. I'll leave you now with a question. Who was the hero of this play? Comment below.
I hope that you enjoyed that video. If you did, like I said, just give it a like and subscribe to my channel and look out for all the content I have upcoming. Thanks again, guys.